perspective.
74 degrees, cloudy. We're going up to a sunny 84.
Flying from LaGuardia Airport, leave extra travel time to get to your terminal and to park. Pre-book your space in long-term parking before arriving at the airport. Consider alternate means of transportation, including public transit. Visit LaGuardiaAirport.com for details.
Wednesday's time, 9:19.
The key to success? Keep it simple, especially when it comes to hiring. And nobody makes it easier than Indeed.com. Post a job in minutes. Set up screener questions. Manage your candidates from one dashboard. According to an independent study, 5 times more hires are made through Indeed than any other job site. New users claim your $50 credit to post a sponsored job at Indeed.com/credit. Indeed, the world's number one job site. Terms, conditions, and quality standards apply.
There are few things in life as rewarding as being part of a worthy cause. Hi, I'm Jim McCann, chairman of 1-800-Flowers.com and co-founder of the nonprofit organization Smile. At Smile, we find it unacceptable that nearly 80% of adults with developmental disabilities are unemployed in the United States. So we decided to try and do something about it. Smile is dedicated to supporting people with special needs by providing meaningful work experiences and social interaction. Smile is making a difference by offering fulfilling jobs.
Disappointing.
Yeah, there were some pretty upset people. You know, I came over here to ride Saturday morning, and there was just a line of cars as far as you could see that way and that way, and people were pretty upset having to be turned away, as well as myself and a lot of other bikers and joggers that were wanting to go through the park.
Saying they couldn't bring it back here to fireworks tonight at this point because there's just so much planning involved.
Even when I heard it was reopened this morning, that it wasn't going to happen.
Are you going?
Yes.
People who love their traditions here of being in this historic park to celebrate July 4th can do that until 10 tonight. Glenn Shock, 10-10 Wayne's at Liberty State Park.
Wayne's News Time, 9:24. Now, the weather may look a little iffy at the moment, but things are about to undergo a dramatic improvement as we hear from AccuWeather's Brian Thompson. Brian.
Yeah, especially over the next hour, Lee, things are going to start to improve. Pretty good downpour moving across Staten Island right now, and continuing to move into the southern part of Brooklyn, right around Coney Island. Probably getting a pretty good downpour in the next 15 minutes or so. But these showers will be out of here, like I said, within the next hour. We'll see a lot of sunshine heading into the afternoon. These clouds are going to move on out, and it looks very comfortable. Low humidity today. High temperatures will be in the mid-80s this afternoon. It looks great for the Macy's fireworks tonight. Temperature at the start of the fireworks, about 77 degrees. Wait.
Taylor should have clear skies for that, which is good for Gary Souza. He designed the show, which he says is not just spectacular, but also very technologically sophisticated.
There's waving ghosts where the stars will present, disappear, and just sort of vanish and present across the image of the show and back again and then create the entire show all over again. So really cool-looking effects that are going to be unique this year.
Sam Williams is the official radio station of the Macy's Fireworks Spectacular. We'll be broadcasting the synchronized soundtrack for the show, so bring the radio along or you can get us on your smartphone if you want to do that. That starts tonight at 9. The fireworks will be of the gastronomic variety at Coney Island today, courtesy of several hundred Nathan's Hot Dogs.
It's a uniquely American event. Conspicuous consumption, gluttony, and hot dogs in Coney Island on the 4th. Nine-time winner and reigning champ of the Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest, Joey Jaws Chestnut, is hoping to win his 10th yellow mustard belt.
It's almost an addiction now. I can't imagine myself not going to that contest.
He faces some stiff competition this year, but he's ready to chow down and maybe even set a new record.
I still get nervous.
Chestnut's fans dubbed him the Great American Hero years ago when he beat legendary competitive eater Takeru Kobayashi and brought the belt back to the U.S. of A. Steve Kastenbaum, New York.
If you want a free hot dog, they'll be handing those out at Coney Island today, but there is a catch. They're vegan hot dogs. PETA is handing them out. Wayne's News Time, 9:26, and a Bloomberg Money Watch on 1010 Wayne's. Here's Gina Cervetti.
When it comes to self-driving cars, conventional wisdom held that rental car companies might one day be left in the dust as consumers used an app to hail robo-taxis and driverless vehicles to take them from point A to B and beyond. But that's not what's happening. Instead, tech giants such as Apple have turned to traditional car industry companies like Hertz to test self-driving technology.
By partnering up, it really shows that someone's got to manage the
reporter David Welch.
Tech companies don't have to do that. They have to provide data, data services, content, infotainment, whatever it is, and rank it in. They don't like big hard assets, manufacturing plants, storage garages, any of that stuff.
Apple is leasing a small fleet of Lexus SUVs from Hertz, which will manage the fleet and take care of the operation, in a deal that arrives at a good time for Hertz, whose stock had plummeted in the past 12 months amid falling profit and revenue. The Apple-Hertz deal echoes a larger agreement between Alphabet's Waymo unit and Avis Budget. Bloomberg Money Watch at 26 and 56 pays every hour. I'm Gina Cervetti for 1010 Wins.
Celebrate America's independence with Macy's and
and 10-10 wins. Join us on July 4th for complete coverage of Macy's Fireworks Spectacular. Listen to the soundtrack of this historic event only on 10-10 wins.
Staples knows that when the leave behinds for your sales call get left behind at your office, it's time. When you need to print 30 pages and you're 300 miles from the office, it's time. And when the intern got the Harrington file, not the Farrington file, it's definitely time. And it's times like these when you can count on Staples. Access your files from email, the cloud, or USB, and then print, copy, fax, or scan them, and get back to business fast. Visit your nearby Staples. It's pro time.
Introducing the new Lucky Charms Shaken Burger Cake. It's a mix of hand-spun vanilla flavored soft serve, tasty bits of Lucky Charms cereal, and memories of watching Saturday morning cartoons in your PJs. The new Lucky Charms Shaken Burger Cake. Relive your childhood in a cup. Maybe it's the magical marshmallow pieces flying up your straw. Maybe it's the magically delicious taste. Whatever the reason, it's a good reason to head over to a Burger King restaurant and try one now. Also, try the Fruit Loop Shake now at Burger King. Shakes available for a limited time only. Participation varies.
Clouds and showers moving out in the next hour or so. Then it will be mostly sunny and pleasant today. We'll have a high of 84. Clear tonight, about 77 when the fireworks fire. Overnight low 69. Then a nice day tomorrow if you're extending your vacation. Mostly sunny with a high of 82. 74 degrees now, cloudy. Humidity at 53. Winds variable at 3. 74 going up to 84. I'm Lee Harris. Winds News Time at the tone, 9:30.
Good morning, I'm Bridget Quinn. If you're listening to us this morning, you just might be working the holiday, and that's just what an Arizona Republican wants his colleagues to do. Jeremy Foster reports Andy Biggs wants them to stay in D.C. this summer to tackle health care.
One of our big promises was the repeal of Obamacare and then to start some reforms.
Well, since that still hasn't happened, Congressman Andy Biggs says he sent a letter to House Speaker Paul Ryan requesting Ryan cancel next month's scheduled recess.
There's no reason in the world why we should be taking 4 or 5 weeks off in August when we have such a major amount of work to do. We also have a bunch to get out, tax reform that we need to tackle.
Nearly a dozen other House members have also signed the letter.
Meantime, Congress is trying to stop the IRS from making you pay a tax penalty if you don't have health insurance. The plan is separate from the Republican efforts to repeal Obamacare. Winds News Time, 9:31. Time for a check from the Dodge Traffic Center and Brian Britton.
Very quiet out there this morning, with a couple of exceptions. We go into Westchester, 684 northbound, exit 4 in Mount Kisco. Some police activity taking out the right lane. Northbound Springbrook, also a disabled vehicle at Dobbs Ferry Road, knocking out the right lane as well. Here's what you need to know about the bridges and tunnels. From the Holland all the way up north to the Mario Cuomo Tappan Zee Bridge, we are looking good. No problems here over or under the East River. In New Jersey, south and west transfer of the Turnpike, Interchange 15E, crash over on the right shoulder. Here's what else is going on as far as the roads. Got a nice ride here. I'm looking at the Belt Parkway right now, live shot right in front of Cross Bay Boulevard. Things moving beautifully as you get in towards the southern state. A fine ride. If you are traveling over to Jones Beach this morning, watching the Meadowbrook southbound, that bunches up big time into Loop Parkway. Wontaw, definitely a better option for you. From the 1010 Winds Transit Desk, New Jersey Transit trains, buses running on a weekend holiday schedule, MTA subways and buses, and PATH on a Saturday schedule. Alternate side is suspended, as are the meter rules. Next traffic and transit in less than 10 minutes. Next breaking traffic alert whenever it happens. I'm Brian Britton on 1010 Winds.
Traffic sponsored by Subway.
Subway restaurants feature a different 6-day sub for $3.50 every day. Today's $3.50 sub of the day is oven roasted chicken. Participating restaurants additional charge for next week.
And here's the 1010 Winds active weather 4-day forecast from the ChevyOffers.com Weather Center. Meteorologist Brian Thompson.
It's going to be a pretty year over the next hour or so, but a couple of downpours are working away across the five boroughs right now. It's raining over most of Staten Island, and these downpours now moving into Brooklyn. Could even brush the southern part of Queens here in the next 30 minutes or so before these move on off the coast. But outside of that, things are starting to improve off to our north and west. We're still probably going to have clouds around for another hour or so at least. Maybe even into the 11 o'clock hour before we start to see a lot of sunshine. And it will be a sunny afternoon, low humidity, a high of 84. Tonight mainly clear, low temperatures in the 70s, mid to upper 70s at the start of the Macy's 4th of July fireworks this evening. Later on tonight, we drop to 69 and midtown 63 in some suburbs. Mostly sunny, a nice day tomorrow, high of 82. Intervals of clouds and sunshine Thursday, a high of 77. And then a little more humid by Friday with clouds and some sun. A few periods of rain and a thunderstorm. Right now, it's cloudy and 74 in Central Park, humidity 53%, and the wind northeast at 3. Repeat to the current.
Our temperature is 74, going up to 84 in Midtown. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Brian Thompson on New York's weather station.
We have 77 degrees on Staten Island, 75 in Baychester, 67 at the Acme in Denville. Sponsored by Acme, your favorite local supermarket. Wins News Time 9:34. What the president's up to on this 4th of July? Next.
This is the sound of you fishing on a lake. It's also the sound of you winning $1,000 a day for life. Because when you play Cash for Life from the New York Lottery, you could win $1,000 a day, every day. So you can work less and fish more. Cash for Life from the New York Lottery. If you won $1,000 a day for life, how would you spend it? Drawings every Monday and Thursday. Please play responsibly. You must be 18 or older to purchase a lottery ticket.
Looking for a new way to make money? Look no further. Drive with Uber. Earn great money and set your own schedule. Uber can help you get a commercial license and will guarantee you earn $1,250 a week when you start. Plus, they'll give you a $250 new driver reward. Call 844-NYC-DRIVE. Even if you don't have a car, you can rent one for free for 2 weeks from a participating dealer. Hurry, this offer won't be around forever. So what are you waiting for? Call 844-NYC-DRIVE. That's 844-NYC-DRIVE. Terms and conditions apply. Visit uber.com/drive-NYC for details.
Wins News Time 9:35. President Trump is expected to host a picnic for armed services members and their families at the White House today. This after spending the July 4th weekend at his Bedminster, New Jersey golf club. David Carley reports on the president's latest tweets.
An escalation of the president's battle with the media continued this holiday weekend.
The fake media tried to stop us from going to the White House, but I'm president and they're not.
Now one Republican accusing the president of trying to weaponize distrust.
The White House is confirming this morning that President Trump will meet Russia's President Putin on Friday. President Trump has spoken with the last surviving member of the World War II-era Doolittle Raiders ahead of this Independence Day. He thanked 101-year-old Lieutenant Colonel Dick Cole of Comfort, Texas, for his service as the co-pilot of the lead B-25 bomber during the 1942 raid on Tokyo. Wins News Time 9:35. A vigil will be held outside the hospital Thursday as the six survivors of Friday's shooting at Bronx, Lebanon continue to improve. Of the four being treated there, a doctor shot in the neck by former employee Henry Cole's Rampage has been discharged. The other three are stable at Mount Sinai. One victim is out of a coma, another is also stable now, but still needs more surgeries. A security guard rescues two people from a Bronx fire. Alex Bonero tells the Daily News he was walking to his job on East 163rd Street when he saw the flames and swung into action.
He's been in the third floor, screaming, where's mom? I ran upstairs and
broken out just before noon yesterday. Panera says the boy, who seemed to be about 3 years old, seemed to be okay when he put him in the ambulance. He says the elderly woman he saved had severe burns on her arms. Wins News Time 9:37.
September 11th, it affected every American. Late night meeting was a ship. Miles after 9/11, the air swirling all over Manhattan was filled with toxic dust and fumes. Many who were exposed to these toxins now have 9/11 related cancers. If you lived, worked, or stooped over the president of Lower Manhattan in the months after the 9/11 attacks and have been diagnosed with cancer or a respiratory illness, you may be entitled to free health care and tax-free compensation from the $7 billion federal 9/11 Victim Compensation Fund. The Victim Compensation Fund has been extended for new claims, but there are strict deadlines to file your claim. Call now 1-855-WTC-INFO for a free 9/11 compensation consultation. 1-855-WTC-INFO. There will be no fee unless you receive compensation. First responders and all downtown workers and residents, this is your chance to receive compensation from the 9/11 fund, but you must act now. Call Turley, Hanson, and Rosasco. 1-855-WTC-INFO. 1-855-WTC-INFO. Or visit 911cancerclaim.com. 911cancerclaim.com.
Wins News Time 9:38, and now 1010 Wins Entertainment. Tell me, Julia. Much longer. Downey says he never wants to blow it for the last six or seven movies. He says he wants to hang up his jersey before, quote, it's embarrassing. He will return for Infinity Wars next year. Natalie Maines of the Dixie Chicks has filed for divorce from her husband of 17 years. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. actor Adrian Pastor TMZ reports the 42-year-old singer is citing irreconcilable differences and is asking for joint custody of their two teenagers. About Scarlett Johansson's romantic travails.
Thank you so much.
Page 6 reports she's back with SNL's Colin Jost. The two responded Thursday at the Palm at the Hunting Inn in East Hampton looking cozy, according to a Post spy. With News Time 9:39.
Happy 4th of July, America. This year, Hyundai wants to celebrate with you. Yes, you. With amazing savings on our most popular models. It's called the 4th of July sales event, and it features explosive savings on the Sonata. And it makes Ford. And the Tucson. And for the grand finale, America. Standard on every new Hyundai. There's no better time than the 4th of July to feel the freedom of a 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. So visit your Hyundai dealer now before these deals go up in smoke. Better is the reason to buy Hyundai, and the 4th of July sales event is the reason to buy now. Hurry in today.
Jersey City's fireworks to exchange place along New York Harbor.
hang in there. It's simply too late to reverse the plan. Get the fireworks show back here. One shot. 10-10 wins. At Liberty State Park.
From Windsor's time 9:43. Forecast looking good for those now open beaches. Active weather meteorologist Brian Thompson.
Yeah, we'll be improving here virtually on the clouds overhead right now. Pretty good downfall looking its way through Brooklyn. Nice and good. Most of Brooklyn's seeing a pretty good downfall right now, especially down toward Coney Island. It's a pretty heavy rain right now to Staten Island. We'll be moving through the south shore of Long Island in the next hour or so. And then the clouds will start to break for some sunshine. It's going to be a nice afternoon. Lots of sun, high up to about 84 degrees. It's going to be pretty comfortable, too. Not all that humid. And for the fireworks this evening, really nice weather, too. Mainly clear, not really that hazy, as the humidity won't be that high. And temperature at the start of the fireworks, about 77 degrees. Bridget?
All right, we thank you, Brian Thompson. Wins News Time 9:44.
Staples knows that when the leave behinds for your sales call get left behind at your office, it's time. When you need to print 30 pages and you're 300 miles from the office, it's time. And when the intern got the Harrington file, not the Farrington file, it's definitely time. And it's times like these when you can count on Staples. Access your files from email, the cloud, or USB, and then print, copy, fax, or scan them, and get back to business fast. Visit your nearby Staples. It's pro time.
I'm Eric Bolling, host of the Fox News specialist and best-selling author of Wake Up America. In my new book, The Swamp, I take you inside the outrageous history of Washington, D.C. politics. You'll be stunned by the lobbyists, the liars, and just plain sleazy behavior of the people we elect. But The Swamp also cripples our nation, betrays our values, and costs taxpayers hundreds of billions of dollars. It's time to drain the swamp. My new book shows how President Trump can do it. Get The Swamp wherever books and audio are sold. New from St. Martin's Press.
Wins News Time 9:45 and now 10:10 Wins Sports, sponsored by Brooklyn Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Here's Mike McGann.
All right, Bridget, home cooking was the charm after those two gut-wrenching losses in Houston. Masahiro Tanaka continued his Yankee resurgence with seven strong innings, Chase Headley three RBIs, and the Yanks also benefited from a splash. Good luck.
Will Tapper back to the mound to throw home, and he is safe. The ball gets away from Bailey.
Mechanics that led to two losses last week. He credits the coaching staff.
I've been working with Larry and Marky, both in coach. Just trying to work on keeping things simple. I was getting out of the mechanics. There's some stuff that I'm doing now that, is taking me back to where I first started last couple years.
Not from the Yes Network. Red Sox also won on Monday. They still lead the Yankees by 3. Mike Trout missed next week's All-Star game. He was voted a starter, but the New Jersey native's thumb still has not quite healed. In Washington, Nationals made it 8 wins in 11 games this season over the Mets. Ryan Raper in the walk-off single for a 3-2 Mets victory. Seth Lugo will pitch today's 11 a.m. game in D.C., still waiting on the Mets batting order. Yoenis Cespedes will sit this one out, but Curtis Granderson's status remains up in the air. The Post reporting the Mets are interested in bringing back Bartolo Colon, but will wait until at least Thursday when he clears waivers and becomes a full free agent. Wimbledon, second day of opening round action, Juan Martín Del Potro and number one women's seed Angelique Kerber among those on the court this morning. And from the NBA, rumors buzzing about a possible sign-and-trade deal that would send Derrick Rose from the Knicks to the Bucks. Sports at 15 and 45 around the clock. Mike McCann, 10:10 Wins Sports.
Wins News Time, 9:47.
Attention, think you're stuck in your current vehicle lease or loan? Think again. Brooklyn Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram has been designated the unofficial headquarters of the Early Lease or Loan Buyout Program. You can now terminate your lease or loan early, no matter the make or model, or the number of payments you have remaining. Brooklyn Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram can buy out your current lease or loan. Even if you do not want to purchase a vehicle from us, we still want to buy you out. Keep the cash in your pocket or put it towards a new vehicle of your choice. Get into a new 2017 Jeep Grand Cherokee, Dodge Durango, Jeep Compass, or other vehicle in stock. Get a new car, possibly for the same price or less than your current payment, or just get some extra cash. See us during the summer series events at Brooklyn Chrysler, 2286 Blackwood Avenue, or at BrooklynChrysler.com. That's BrooklynChrysler.com. Click on
TrophyChrysler.com.
TrophyChrysler.com. Jeep Ram will terminate your existing lease or loan subject to primary lender approval and equity of vehicle. Call 855-434-4685 for details.
1010 Wins coverage of Macy's 4th of July Fireworks Spectacular is sponsored in part by Applegate Natural and Organic Meat.
Wins News Time 948, Chris Christie is defending his family trip to a closed New Jersey beach Sunday.
I think I've proven over the last 8 years that I don't really care about political optics. I care about right and wrong. And if I have a choice to make, I think I've proven over the last 8 years that I have a choice to make between my family and political optics, and I'm going to pick my family.
That is from last night's news conference announcing the budget deal that reopened the beaches. Christie says that they had flown that plane over that beach, and I was sitting next to a 25-year-old blonde. That's a story. Christie also notes that he was at the state-owned governor's beach house. Run for governor, he says, and you can have the residence. Martin Shkreli, a former pharmaceutical company CEO who raised the price of life-saving drug by 5,000%, is on trial right now for federal securities fraud. In motion yesterday, prosecutors asked the judge to make him stop talking outside of court. They say his statements could taint the jury. The defense says the so-called pharma bro is being baited into making public statements. The Pentagon is confirming North Korea has launched another missile.
The missile was a land-based intermediate-range missile, according to U.S. Pacific Command in Hawaii. It says it tracked the missile from the launch. NORAD in Colorado Springs was watching it and quickly determined it was not a threat to North America. The South Korean military has said the missile traveled 577 miles before splashing down in the Sea of Japan.
Says it's working with the U.S. to try to determine the missile's actual capability. This is North Korea's 11th missile test this year, and President Trump has tweeted of North Korea's leader, "Does this guy have anything better to do with his life?" Mr. Trump continues, "Perhaps China will put a heavy move on North Korea and end this nonsense once and for all." In the U.S.-backed battle against ISIS, Syrian Democratic Forces have advanced into a heavily fortified portion of Raqqa. ISIS fighters have been keeping them away by planting mines and IEDs in an historic wall there, but the American